Hello everyone. It is with great pleasure today that I have with me Dr. Aditya Vasudev Agarwal, one of our students from DAMS US Emily Edge face-to-face classes from Delhi. And Aditya has scored a very high score of 264. It's one of our highest scores so far that we've had in DAMS. And he is here today to discuss his strategies, how we helped him or how any other resource helped him so that he can share with you his journey. What I remember of Aditya is, of course, that he first of all had a lot of questions when he first came to see me. He came with his family. So I realized that he had a very, very, helpful family, somebody to support him with him all the time. And I do think that his sincerity and the way with which he managed coming to me in the second year itself and making sure that within a year and a little more than a year of that, he has managed to give his exam. So I just wanted to talk to, first of all, instead of me talking, I'm going to give take over and tell Aditya to talk about his journey. I'll ask him a few questions that will give you all an insight as to what made a difference to him. So welcome, Aditya.
Thank you, ma'am.
And congratulations for this wonderful score.
Thank you so
much, I think
ma'am.
You just are going to keep increasing.
Thank
you, ma'am. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and your journey to reach this place?
Ma'am, first of all, I would like to thank you, ma'am, and all the DAMS team and Dr. Sumer sir for creating this platform and like helping me to get such a high score, and because of that I'm sitting here having an interview with you.
Yeah.
And so so about USMLE, so like as I did my NEET UG, so after I joined my college in the first year itself, I got to know about USMLE, so I tried to find things, tried to find resources like how to do USMLE. So like searching on the net, I found DAMS and I talked to Mala ma'am, and she like gave me a timeline that how should I go about USMLE and what resources I should use, and she suggested me that their face-to-face classes, and I joined that in my fourth semester, and I felt that that was really helpful, and because the teachers they taught us so high-yield and conceptual things that were asked directly in the exam, and she also gave me a personalized timeline and guidance, and that helped me a lot. You know, it saved me from a lot of glitches that some students may have if they do not have a mentor. So that is, I think, the main edge of this program.
I think that's very sweet of you to say
Thank
that.
You, ma'am.
And I know that whenever a student does really well, a belief in any system that he's following, you know, sometimes it may not be the system. It is your belief and your own hard work that takes you where you are.
Thank you,
so
ma'am.
I would definitely give you a lot of credit for where you are today because, you are very clear. So did you know from your first year of joining that you wanted to do USMLE?
So I heard about USMLE and I had this thing in mind that I had to go to US, I had to experience their culture, like what is in there in US, like obviously US is like best for residency. So I started like studying about gathering resources basically about USMLE, and then when I met Mala ma'am, like I was sure that I had to do this because this was my calling. So
okay, that's great. So and then when you started studying, you realized it was under you, but then I'm sure since you started very early, were there any particular challenges you face? Because many students tell me that third year may be too early to give. So as a third, while giving the exam in third year, we have our own college work and we have so much semester work also. We have our exams from college plus the classes we used to have, I remember, weekend classes. And so the entire weekend used to go in just studying for these classes.
Yes,
so how did you manage your time and did you face any challenges for this?
Ma'am. So indeed, yes, the exam is like quite tough because the exam is quite clinical. And in the first and second year itself, like we are not exposed to that much of clinical scenario that the exam asks. And about time, yes, there was a lot of time crunch, but indeed COVID had this benefit because there was lockdown and there was no classes in my college, so I could concentrate on my USMLE. So that helped me a lot. And basically there's this gap between the second year and the USMLE exam is basically the clinical thing. So even in second year, we are not able to diagnose conditions. And in the USMLE exam, they present it in a clinical scenario and link it to a basic science question. and then we have to answer it. And some questions are about diagnosis. So that is the main, caveat or hardship that Indian students do face. I think about
Yeah,
USMLE,
so
and
yeah, correct.
classes like are quite helpful in that because
They bridge that gap
they
for you.
exactly bridge that gap.
Right, correct. So this is what many people say that when you are faced with severe clinical questions right at the beginning of your second year or second year end when you started your USMLE prep, you tend to have a gap between the
Exactly.
theory which you have learned and how to understand and apply it in your
Yes, ma'am.
questions. So I think, like you said, the question, the DAMS lectures helped
Yes,
you.
ma'am.
Now you have to also tell me that what was your study pattern like and what exactly did you do to achieve this great score? Did
Okay.
you break your studies every day? Did you have a routine that you followed? Because everyone who is looking at you would want to emulate you. So did you tell us a little bit about your daily routine, how much you studied, what part of whether you made notes, what other resources you used apart from DAMS, which also was really helpful for you. You can talk about that.
Okay, so I think the USMLE preparation is divided into two phases. One is the resource gathering and information gathering phase, and the second phase is when you practice a lot of questions and get into the habit of solving one block each day of UWorld or maybe some other question like bank like AMBOSS or etc. So having a plan in mind is definitely helpful. So like first, like in my second year itself, I gathered resources and I watched DAMS lectures and other resources also pertaining to USMLE. So that helped me build a foundation. So along with that, what I realized that and what I suggest that you can like have a question bank, and like I did AMBOSS, I found that useful, and that question bank will help you to like mold your basic science knowledge into clinical knowledge and apply it into your exam.
All
So
right.
that is like really helpful. And in your dedicated period, that is usually 3 to 4 months for an IMG. So in your dedicated period, you should do like the UWorld question bank, like every day 40 questions, like, and get up at four, get up at 7 and start the block at 8 and then review whole of the block. That is, I think, the most important thing because like every question has its explanations and you don't know what explanation might be there in your real exam. So I suggest reading whole of the explanation of the questions along with your wrong answers, your incorrects, everything is important.
Okay, that's really a good tip. And what I would also want you to probably tell the students is that which are the main three resources, if you talk about three resources that really helped you, including the lectures, you can just tell three resources because first aid is also very highly recommended. You have the UWorld, which people say is very good. Like my last few students who gave the exam told that, they did just DAMS notes with first aid and UWorld. So you can tell us about your, and also I would after this talk to you about the change in pattern and whether you can you could realize any change in pattern from what you studied and what you gave. So tell us about these two things, three main resources and a little bit about the change in the
Okay,
pattern.
so like three main resources, I would divide this into like videos and your like own made notes and question banks.
Okay.
So videos, you can watch any videos, and like I found DAMS videos and DAMS lectures and their handwritten notes very useful. And second thing is your question bank, and first is always your guiding book, I think. And if you want extra points, like if you are in second year, you can do Pathoma also and along with its videos.
All right. So these were the main resources that you used and you felt it was
Yes,
easy. What about the change? Because as of October,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
everybody was very scared and asking that there's going to be a lot of focus on something other than what has been in focus so far. So could you tell us a few points on what you felt was very high yield and what students and maybe even teachers alike should be able to focus on?
Okay, so yes, exactly. I found like there was a change in the way that USMLE used to ask questions in the exam and in the way that I solved questions. So basically, there was a lot of communication questions that were asked, and ethics has been removed, that it is in the like content outline. And basically, the thing is that in UWorld or in maybe other question banks, they usually give you like the buzzwords and the main clinical scenario and the like the highest yield finding. That won't be the case every time with your real exam. In your real exam, they can give you some subtle findings that could cue you into the question, but you are obviously not sure. So in all, you should read the topic whole and understand the basic concept behind it.
Right.
And because in my exam, I didn't feel that even a single question was memorizing or something. It was all
totally
applying.
Application.
Yeah, totally
okay.
application.
So what about you? I think when we just spoke, you said something about the content being more with toxicology questions, zyada the, or whatever. So even subject wise, aap bata sakte,
yeah.
okay? Which was what you felt were the topics that students should concentrate on, which were not initially so much of high yield, you know?
Okay, so I think behavioral health, that covers communication and that covers substance abuse poisoning.
Okay.
That was quite high yield. CT scans, I thank Dr. Sumer for that. CT scans, X-rays, MRIs, that was asked. And ECGs were asked. And I think pathology questions were more conceptual and not just findings and
clinical
histology.
Things.
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
Histo was also
asked.
All right. So
and endoscopic findings were asked.
All right. So this is also a part of what was covered in the
yes,
curriculum
exactly.
for you, and that made it a little easier. So I basically wanted students to understand and talk to Aditya. I mean, at least have this video and understand that somebody who starts in the second year can score as high as 264, which is literally the top 10%, not even the top 1% of students get into that high score. So you need to know that students from the second and third year, without knowing much about clinical medicine in their medical college, coming from India, can score this high score if you have the right attitude, number one. If you have a good goal and good direction given by teachers and anyone who's guiding you. And thirdly, if you find the right resource, you know. So just rephrasing whatever he said, he felt you world when you come till the U world, before that, the stuff that he did was attending the classes, making your notes, having a few extra additional resources like say Pathoma or Emboss really helped him, because that groomed him as to what he needs to study. And finally, when he did the U world, how many revisions of U world do you recommend?
Ma'am, I if you haven't done any question bank in the past, I recommend 2 passes. And And it also depends on the first pass percentage. If you are less than 70%, I recommend a second pass. But I was between 80 to 90, so I did one pass only. And the most important thing for the exam, I felt, is building endurance for that 8-hour long beast exam.
Correct.
I was really, really exhausted. I felt that I'll just fall down after the exam.
Right.
So,
did you do a lot of offline NBMEs or the online ones? Did you feel they had any relation to the exam?
Yeah, I think the newer NBMEs that were close to the exam, not obviously not exactly same, but the points, the concepts were similar.
Okay.
And that I think they were helpful.
What about the UL self-assessment 1 and 2? At what point in your preparation you took them?
Okay, so UL self-assessment 2, I took, I think, 10 days before my exam. And UL self-assessment 1, I think I took 3 weeks before my exam.
And how did you fare in them?
So I had, ma'am, UWorld self-assessment 1 was 277.
Oh.
And UWorld self-assessment 2 was 271. So obviously they kind of over-predict.
Okay.
If it's going beyond 265, it is over-predicting.
Okay.
And below it, then it might not over-predict. So
all
it
right.
depends. Yes,
and when you came back from your exam, when
yes,
you think back and think of how you did, what are the kind of breaks you took during your exam? And do you think you would like to advise something for the exam day for the students? And do you think that what you scored is what you expected, or were you scared after you came back from the exam? What was your reaction when you gave the exam?
Okay, so after I came from the exam, I was it is so weird. The exam is nowhere near UWorld or anything, but it is the exam is weird for everybody. And
yes.
since it is based on percentile based scores, so it doesn't matter
yes.
if you have prepared well and you feel the exam is weird. So obviously it is weird for everybody and
yes.
you will get a good score.
Yes.
And one thing I recommend everybody is to have a good night's sleep, 8 to 10 hours before the exam, because I could not sleep even 1 minute before exam, and I had this adrenaline rush
mm-hmm.
and my heart was pounding out and palpitations, and over that I had coffee because
oh.
I had to take the exam.
Right.
So that was very challenging for me. And time your breaks, that is most important. Have something that is more in protein and fats. like you can have sandwiches or something like protein bars, and I think and pack well for the exam.
Right. So how many breaks did you take and how
So
did you
ma'am,
manage?
I did first two blocks without a break, then I did a 30 minutes break, and then I did two blocks, then another break of 10 to 15 minutes. Then after every block, I took a 5 to 10 minutes break, ma'am.
Right. And tell me one more thing. Probably one of the last questions I need to ask you is, did you feel that being sincere from day one in your medical school helped you, or your background, like were you also a sincere student in your medical school and did you do your first year well and were you in sync with the subjects and did you think that that helped you also score this high?
Yeah, so exactly, it does help you. Like, if you are sincere, if you know things, if you know basics, that does help you in the exam, because sometimes there are things in the exam which you might not have had on first aid or UWorld or any other question bank, but you may have had heard that in your classroom. So if that is the case, that will really help you. So
Right.
like being sincere and focusing on your first 2 years of medical school is really important, I think.
Great. So what are your plans now, Aditya, and where do you see yourself 5 years from now? What is the thing you're pursuing after this? Because we hope once you get into your residency, we will again interview you so that you can tell people
Yes,
about your
ma'am.
journey for the
Thank you.
residency. So just tell us in two, three lines about what are you planning to do now
Okay,
henceforth.
so like after step one, I'm planning to do my step two CK in internship and probably applying for internal medicine.
Okay, that sounds really good. I wish you all the best. I
Thank you,
think
ma'am.
you have had a wonderful first step towards the journey, and
Thank
I
you,
think
ma'am.
you'll just be jumping in leaps and bounds after this because
Thank you, ma'am.
once you have a good score, it always pumps you up.
Yes,
And
ma'am.
we are always here by your side to help you.
Thank you
So
so
all the
much,
very
ma'am.
best. Stay in touch. And for those of you who are watching, if you need to know more about Aditya's journey or our help with all the students who've been doing the USMLE with us, then please get in touch with me for at USMLE@damsdelhi.com and I will help you with all your questions. Thank you so much,
Thank you,
Aditya, for
ma'am. Thank
sparing
you
your
so much,
time and
ma'am.
all the
Thank you,
best
ma'am.
to you.
Thank
Thank
you,
you.
ma'am.